जय जय राधा माधव जयो कुंज बिहारी। गोपी जन वल्लभ जय गिरी वरधारी जय जय जशोदानंदन व्रज जनरंजन जमुना तीरावन चार जय जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे जयो राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ राधे राधे जय जय प्रभुपाद 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 जय प्रभुपाद नीताए गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल गौर हरि बोल
जय श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस प्रभुजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शत श्री श्रील एसी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस प्रभुजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शत श्री श्रीमती दिवान की भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय। नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से गौ श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासदि गौरभक्तवृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन की जय। गंगामय जमुनामय की जय। भक्ति देवी से तुलसी महारानी की जय। निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे ऑल ग्लोरियस टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरियस टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरियस टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरियस टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। सो टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो फर्स्ट चैप्टर सिक्स एंड वर्स नंबर 16। ध्यायतश्चरणाम्भोजं भावनिर्जिता चेतसा भावनिर्जित चेतसा औत्कंठ्या श्रीकलाक्षक्ष हृदयासीन्मेष निर्हरिहे। ध्यायश्चरणाम्भोजं ध्यायतश्चरणाम्भोजं भावनिर्जित चेतसा औत्कंठ्या श्रीकलाक्षस्य हृद्यासीन्मेषनैर्हरि। ध्यायतश्चरणाम्भोजं भावनिर्जितचेतसा औत्कंठ्या श्रीकलाक्षस्य हृदयासीन्मेष निर्हरि। माता जी ट्रांसलेशन प्रपोर्ट बाय हिज दिव्य ग्रेस एसी भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी महाराज श्रील प्रभुपाद। ट्रांसलेशन: As soon as I began to meditate upon the lotus feet of the Personality of Godhead, with my mind transformed in transcendental love, tears rolled down from my eyes, and without delay, the Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, appeared on the lotus of my heart. Purport: The word bhava is significant here. The bhava stage is attained after one has transcendental affection for the Lord. The first initial stage is called Shraddha, or liking the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And in order to increase that liking, one has to associate with the pure devotees of the Lord. The third stage is practice the prescribed rules and regulations of devotional service. This will dissipate all sorts of misgivings and remove all personal deficiencies that hamper progress in devotional service. When all misgivings and personal deficiencies are removed, there is strengthened faith in the transcendental matter, and the taste for it increases in greater proportion. This stage leads to attraction, and after there is a bhava, or a prior stage to unalloyed love for God. All the above different stages are but different stages of development of transcendental love. Being so surcharged with the transcendental love, there comes a strong feeling of separation, which leads to 8 different kinds of ecstasies. Tears from the eyes of a devotee is an automatic reaction. And because Sri Narada Muni, in his previous birth, attained that stage very quickly after his departure from home, it was quite possible for him to perceive the actual presence of the Lord, which is tangibly experienced by his developed spiritual senses विदाउट मेटीरियल थिंज। ओम ज्ञानति मरंदस ज्ञानंजन शिलाकय चक्षुर उन्मिलितम जनतस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। नमः ओम विष्णु पादाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी नामने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चात देशतारे। हरे कृष्णा। वेरी ब्यूटीफुल पर्पोट। इन द पर्पोट दिस नाइन स्टेजेस ऑफ डिवोशनल सर्विस आर एक्सप्लेन। आदो श्रद्धा तथा साधु संग तथा भजन क्रिया अनर्थ निवृत्ति एंड देन निष्ठा रुचि आसक्ति एंड भाव। सो दीज आर द नाइन स्टेजेस एक्सप्लेन इन द पर्पोट। द फर्स्ट इज आदो श्रद्धा फेथ। श्रद्धा मीन्स फेथ। दिस इज अ स्पेशल प्रिविलेज ऑफ अ ह्यूमन बीइंग टू हैव फेथ। श्रद्धा दिस इज नॉट अवेलेबल। दिस चॉइस इज नॉट गिवन टू द एनिमल्स बर्ड्स एंड अदर स्पीसीज। दे हैव नो चॉइस। देर इज नो फेथ। देर इज नो श्रद्धा। बट ह्यूमन बीइंग हैज दिस स्पेशल प्रिविलेज। बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली कलयुग अटैक्स फर्स्ट ऑन द श्रद्धा पार्ट फेथ। इफ यू स्पीक अबाउट गॉड द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दे आस्क डिड यू सी गॉड। वी कैनॉट सी गॉड देयरफॉर वी डोंट बिलीव। रिसेंटली वी सेलिब्रेटेड जन्माष्टमी। ब्रह्माजी अलॉन्ग विथ ऑल द गॉड्स ऑफ द हेवनली प्लैनेट एंड ऑल्सो अर्थ भूमि वेंट अप्रोच लॉर्ड नारायण ऑन सेतुसेतु द्वीप। लॉर्ड नारायण गेव हिज मैसेज टू ब्रह्मा थ्रू हिज हार्ट इन हिज हार्ट एंड कृष्णा सेड ओके आई विल अपियर नाउ सो यू ऑल अपियर। सो ब्रह्माजी रिसीव्ड अ मैसेज फ्रॉम कृष्णा एंड ऑल द गॉड्स ऑफ द हेवनली प्लैनेट दे ऑल एक्सेप्टेड दैट यू हैव सीन गॉड। Although we have not seen God, Krishna was not seen by these other gods. Only Brahmaji received a message. He also didn't see. He only received the message. Just imagine, the big, big gods of the heavenly planet, sometimes they are also not qualified to see God. They just have to keep faith and believe that, okay, Brahmaji has seen and Brahmaji has got the message. And they believed it. But Kali Yuga, unfortunate creatures, even the beggar on the street, he also demands, okay, if you say God exists, then show me, let him come in front of me and then I will believe. So, this is a direct attack on a faith. Many times people ask, oh, this God and everything is mythology. Krishna lifted Govardhan Hill on the little finger of his left hand. It's all mythology. How is that possible? One person can lift a mountain and that too on his left hand. When we see a man lifting a plastic chair, it's not a big thing. It's normal. If a human being lifting a plastic chair, it's a normal thing. It's okay. But if an ant or an insect, small worm or ant sees that a human being lifting a chair, plastic chair, that ant becomes, my God, mesmerized. Who is this person? He is lifting a mountain called chair. Because for us, chair is normal, common. But for an ant, chair is like as big as a mountain. So immediately that ant rushes and runs towards the society and informs everyone, oh, today I have seen a special phenomena. What is that? One person was lifting a mountain. And others say, oh, it's all mythology. You believe that someone is lifting a mountain? See, for us, it is natural. It's very simple. But for an ant, it's like lifting a mountain. Similarly, if we see God and bring that God into our level, then naturally, we can't believe that God can lift a mountain. But we must know that God is not unlimited like us. His energy, his power is unlimited. We have a tiny brain, we have a tiny energy. God, why only lifting a mountain? He is floating all the big, big planets, not just a mountain, big, big planet floating on a air, and not with his hand, simply by his will power. He says that, okay, all these planets which are heavier, billion times heavier than the mountain, let them float in the air. And they are all floating, just by his will power. So we must know God through the eyes of the scriptures, not with our limited brain. Many times people also ask this question, oh, your God is very powerful. Huh? He can lift a mountain, he can float the universe. Okay. But then why do you have to give bath to him? Yeah, every day we give bath. Vithala is then Abhishek every day, Lord Balaji, and every ISKCON temple we give bathing, you know, bath to Krishna. If your God cannot even take bath on his own, you have to give him bath, wear a clothes, and then feed him with your hand, offer a bhoga, then what kind of God he is? He cannot even his own service, his own take care of his own body. And you are expecting that he will protect you? So my dear sir, here at this level, there is no question of logic and arguments and show me this and that. It's a question of love. It's a matter of love. When a baby is born in someone's family, two, three months old baby, now she's totally dependent on the mother. And how many times she passes stool and urine? He or she passes stool and urine? Many times a day, right? And mother, not as a burden, but out of love and affection, cleans the body of a child. So, when we see a small baby which is totally dependent on you, we take care of the child so nicely. Why only just giving a bath, even cleaning the stool and urine? It's a matter of love, it's not a logic. So similarly, Krishna appears in the deity form to accept the service from his devotees. And therefore, we, out of love and affection, as a gratitude, we offer service to him. So, why people don't want to accept God? Because they think that, you know, accepting God means there is hindrance of enjoyment in my enjoyment. So therefore, they don't accept God. But we must understand that human life is so precious. Only in this human life we can understand God. There was one person, he was walking on the road, on the cliffs of the mountain, and then somehow he fell down in the big ditch. So now he was worried, how I can climb up? It's a deep ditch. So fortunately there was one wooden staircase or wooden flight of stairs. So then he had a chance to take the help of that wooden stairs or wooden flight of stairs, and he can climb up. But because it was a very, it was a winter season, it was very cold, what he did, he started burning that food, the wood, that wooden staircase, because it was very cold, so that wooden staircase gave some heat to him. And he enjoyed that heat. But how long you can enjoy that heat? For some time, as long as that wooden stair is there. After some time, the wooden stairs burnt. And now there was no even any facility for him to climb up on the mountain. Similarly, this human body is like a wooden flight of stair, wooden staircase. If we use it for sense gratification, then you have lost the opportunity. If you use this staircase to climb up on the mountain, that is the purpose. So similarly, this human body is meant for achieving God consciousness, Krishna prema. But then someone may say, but there is no enjoyment in Krishna bhakti. Who says there is no enjoyment? Now these are the 9 stages explained here. Ado, Shraddha, Tatha, Sadhu, Sangha, Bhajana, Kriya. As soon as one engages in Krishna bhakti, Bhajana, Kriya, what happens? The first two effects. First is Klesha, Agni, and Shubhada. Shubhada means bhakti brings all auspiciousness in the lives of a devotee. And Kleshagni means Krishna removes all the kleshas, all the difficulties, anxieties from the life of a devotee. So who says there is no enjoyment? Actually in bhakti, enjoyment without anxiety. In material life, there is little enjoyment but with full of anxiety. But in bhakti, enjoyment without any anxiety. So then someone may ask, if Krishna removes all my anxieties, but still there are so many problems in my life, how can you say that Krishna is removing all my problems and solving all my problems and removing all my anxieties? My dear sir, you don't even know what Krishna is, how Krishna is acting in your life and what kind of problems he is solving from your life. During the Mahabharata war went on for 18 days. So every day, at the end of the day, Krishna would get down from the chariot first, and then Arjuna would come down. At the final day, 18th day, Krishna told Arjuna, you get down first. Arjuna said, our normal, general norm is that you get down first. He said, just follow my instruction. You get down first. So Arjuna got down, and then Krishna finally got down from the chariot. As soon as Krishna came down from the chariot, the whole chariot burned into ashes. Of course, the horses were not, horses were unyoked from the chariot. So, and then Arjuna was shocked. What happened? Then Krishna said, Arjuna, during this war, so many warriors, Athiratis, Maharathis, they were fighting with you simultaneously. You didn't even know. Many warriors were simultaneously fighting with them, and you were counteracting with few, and others were holding so many weapons on your chariot. And without your knowledge, I kept them on the pause level, pause button, around your chariot. All those weapons were held by my power. And now war is over, there is no need. Let this weapon burn this whole chariot. So Arjuna didn't know this. Even devotee's life also. Krishna is removing all the big, big boulders from the path of devotees. And only small, small pebbles are remaining on the path. And when we walk barefoot, we see that these pebbles are pricking our foot. And we see, oh my God, there is so much suffering in my life. There are so many troubles. My dear sir, you don't even know all the big, 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 big mountainous boulders are already removed by Krishna. And he doesn't tell you that, okay, I have done this for you and I have done that for you. He's very, he doesn't want any credit. So Krishna is removing all the problems in devotee's life. One of a devotee, he writes in one of his book, Krishna is so eager, Radha and Krishna, they are so eager to know our progress in bhakti. It's not that only we are eager to meet Krishna and enter in the spiritual world. Radha and Krishna are a million times more eager than us. When someone accepts bhakti, Radha and Krishna, they talked amongst the, between them. They talk about this devotee who is making any progress. Oh, today he chanted 64 rounds. Oh, today was a Nirjal Ekadasi. He did this, he did that. This is not exaggeration, it's a fact. Radha and Krishna personally discuss about every devotee, how they are doing, what are their problems. Everything is discussed by Radha and Krishna. So, but then someone may say, but still, you say that chanting Hare Krishna mantra once, you become free from all the sinful activities, but I don't see that result in my life. My dear sir, just wait. Whatever the father has, all the property belongs to the son. Let that son become matured. At the age of 4 and 5, the father does not put everything, all his property in the name of his son. Let him become responsible. Let him become matured. Let him understand the importance of money and the property. Then it is yours. I don't keep it with myself. It is yours. So similarly, whatever we are chanting, doing any bhakti, all those benefits are stocked, kept safe in one place. But why is not rewarded at this moment? Because the small child of 2-3 age, if you give a $1 million check to a child, it doesn't understand the value of the check. And he is ready to exchange with a chocolate, some Cadbury chocolate in one hand, and then immediately he will give you that $1 million check. Similarly, at this moment we cannot handle that ecstasy. It's a 440 or 420 for whatever, 440 voltage. So, at this moment we cannot bear that ecstasy. We may exchange of this ecstasy of Krishna Prem with a useless sense gratification. So therefore Krishna says, first you become matured. Krishna has a plan for every devotee. He has a personally, he makes a plan for every devotee. So therefore devotee should have this faith that Krishna will surely protect me. Forget about having realizations about bhakti. Even a knowledge of bhakti is sufficient to make us happy. Someone may say, oh, after getting realization, one will become happy. No, even simply having knowledge of bhakti is sufficient to make us happy. One time in the Western countries, some devotees were doing Harinam Sankirtan. And finally at one stop, one of the sannyasi, he was giving a short talk during that Harinam Sankirtan. And one lady was passing by. She heard just one line. She became so ecstatic. And after the talk, she came and thanked Maharaj. Oh, your one line of your talk made my life blissful. And then Sanyasi said, what was that one line? She said, you mentioned in your class that we are not this body, we are spirit soul. And she was very, very fat lady. She was always in anxiety. What will happen to me? My body is so fat. But your one line that I am not this body, this fat body. I am not this fat body. I am a soul. I am ecstatic. I am blissful. You removed all my anxieties. So, not just a realization, even a knowledge of bhakti is sufficient. So the first stage is Ado Shraddha Tatha Sadhu Sangha. So this Bhakti Lata creeper, she grows like a creeper from a minute tiny seed. It keeps growing, 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 and finally it pierces the layer, outer circle of this mundane sphere, and crossing through Viraja, enters Vaikuntha, and finally that Bhakti Lata rests and attains its final destination at the lotus feet of Krishna in Goloka Vrindavan. Amazing point. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur Pad writes that this Bhakti Lata in the beginning is very delicate. Bhakti Lata is very delicate. And then he compares this Bhakti Lata is like a newly born baby girl. Her body is very delicate. So we have to protect her. Just like a parents, they protect their daughter like eyelids protecting the eyes. Because their body is very tender, very delicate. Somebody sent me one video clip. In that clip, one young lady, she is traveling, she is riding the bike in the middle of the night, 12 o'clock. She is alone, she is riding the bike, and suddenly she is surrounded by 20 to 30 goons. Goons means gundas. So now what to do? But it is shown in that clip, she starts fighting with them. She starts punching and kicking them. And within just 5-10 minutes, she defeats all the 20-30 gundas. Wow. Now just see, if any lady, young lady here sees this clip, everyone gets their own confidence. I can also do it. If she can do, I can also do it. My dear sir, it happens only in the movies. It never happened in the real life. Never, till now, never happened in the real life. It happens vice versa. So, why we are mentioning this point? Although there, we don't have any doubt on your strength, but why should we take risk? Because our loving parents, our family members, our relatives, they're waiting for us. It's our responsibility to protect our body, to protect ourselves. So parents, take care of their daughters like our eyelids protect the eyes. So how to protect that? I saw one time in Krishna Balaram temple, the flower, rose flower, the petals are so delicate. In Krishna Balaram, they are very fragrant roses flowers. But as soon as you touch the lotus flower, all the petals, they drip down. So similarly, this material body is, Bhakti Lata, is very fragile, very delicate. So how to protect that Bhakti Lata? By creating a fencing around the Bhakti Lata creeper. What is that fencing? It's association of devotees. Only the association of devotees can protect the creeper from the animals like goats and other insects from eating. Association is very, very important. During the rainy season, the water which drips down from the clouds is very crystal clear, pure. If that drop of water falls in the gutter, in the sewage, it becomes contaminated, it becomes a part of the gutter, part of the sewage. If that drop of water falls on a hot iron, it evaporates within a fraction of seconds. If that drop of water falls in an oyster, it becomes a pearl. It's association, effect of association. And if that drop of water falls in the Mother Ganga, River Ganga, it becomes Ganga Jal. See, association is so important. Our life, our destination is depend on our association. If we associate with a drop of water, associates with the gutter, it becomes a part of gutter. If it associates with the oyster, becomes a pearl. If it associates with the Ganga, pure, it becomes Ganga Jal. So association is very, very important. One time there was a sculptor. He brought two marble pieces. And then he wanted to carve deities out of those two marble pieces. So he started his process, chisel and hammer. The first piece of marble said, oh, it's very painful. I don't want to get carved by you. It's very painful process. So then the sculptor said, okay, if it is your desire, let it remain like this. And then he started carving the second marble piece. And the second marble piece tolerated everything and it became a deity of Krishna. So finally, these both pieces of marble were sold. And one businessman purchased both the marble pieces, but the deity form of Krishna, the marble piece, was kept in the altar, and he got the worship of all the devotees. Everyone started bowing down in front of that marble. Of course, it became a deity afterwards. And the other piece of marble was placed near the shoe stall, where everyone was putting their feet. Now, this one marble piece, it tolerated for some time, and accepted to be carved by the sculptor, therefore got the position like a god. So similarly, in bhakti process, when a guru, spiritual master and the devotees, they carved our life, we have to tolerate. What is the tolerance? We are a neophyte, we are a sadhakas, and same way, our fellow members, they are also sadhakas, they are also practicing. So what do we have to do? Tolerate. Even if you don't agree with them, but just tolerate and have patience. While carving, there is so much of pain, you have to tolerate. And have a patience, the right time will come. Everything will be all right. Just like Prabhupada, he had 2,000 manuscript. But when he was traveling, some of those 2,000 pages of manuscript were lost. So what Prabhupada did, he just kept crying and sitting in one place. He started writing again. So having patience. So Rupa Goswami writes next, Anukullasya sankalpa pratikullasya varjanam. Whatever is favorable for devotional service, you accept it. And whatever is unfavorable, you reject it. Asatsanga sadatya chhad anya gita rag lila katha braja rasa pure. Give up the bad association and always remain in the association of devotees. The next process is watering the creeper, bhakti lata creeper. That's very, very important. And that watering, what is that process of watering? It is chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra in the association of devotees. Bhakti, any vidhi or any process, but done in the association, performed in the association of devotees, will have effect. Nam Chintamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasavigraha Purna Shuddho Nitya Mukto Abhinnatvam Nama Namino. Krishna's holy name is non-different from Krishna. So when we associate with Krishna, it purifies our existence. Chanting other mantras can lead us to heavenly planets or other planets. But chanting Hare Krishna mantra is such a beautiful process. It safely carries the jiva from this material existence and places at the lotus feet of Krishna. So, chanting Hare Krishna is like an umbilical cord of a jiva. It nourishes all the jivas and also transports to the spiritual world. Eka Krishna nama kahe sarva papakshay nava vidha bhakti purna nama hoyte hai. Bhakti or chanting Hare Krishna not only removes all the anarthas, but it also removes the propensity to sin, committing sin. That also is removed. And when someone is chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, please listen to this very important point. When someone chants Hare Krishna Mantra, there is no need of any other atonement. Whatever sinful activities or whatever mistake, anything has happened till now in our life. But what is the atonement? Simply chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. When Shukadeva Goswami was narrating Putana's pastime, killing Putana's pastime to Parikshit Maharaj, so he explained that Putana is very cruel, she is a witch, she is a chudel, and then she knows all the black art and black magic and all the tantric and everything. So Parikshit Maharaj became worried. Now she is entering in Vrindavan Dham. What will happen now? So Shukadeva Goswami could understand this. And immediately he quoted, he recited one verse. Nayatra sravanadini rakshoghanani sakarmashu kurvanti satvatam bharatur yatu dhanyascha tatrahi. Very beautiful sloka. He says, Shukadeva Goswami says to Parikshit Maharaj, I know you are in anxiety now. She's such a cruel lady. She will kill everyone. But don't worry. Wherever there is a Sravanadi, wherever there is chanting of Hare Krishna mantra happening in any house, in any area or any place, there cannot be effect of any black art, black magic or so many, you know, so people have problem with Rahu and Shani and all the planets so many things. Sukadeva Goswami gives assurance to Parikshit Maharaj. Even Putana cannot do any harm to Brajavasis or Krishna, because they are always chanting the glories of Krishna's holy name. And therefore, you don't worry. So similarly, we should have full faith that simply by chanting Krishna's holy name, devotees will be protected. One time I asked this question to His Holiness Radhana Swami Maharaji. Maharaji, we hear all this, you know, astrology, Vastu, and this planet, Graha, Rahu, this, that. Are they more powerful than Krishna? Maharaj gave a very beautiful answer. Maharaj said, these Shastras are authentic, real. So just like a Vastu. If you are building a new house, then we should take help of the Shastras, Vastu Shastra, and build your house according to Shastra, because it takes us 5-10 minutes. If it is already more than 100 years old building, and then you have to do so many things, you cannot do anything. So when you have a choice, you have a chance building a new house, so you can refer the Shastra. Just like there were two devotees, they were doing parikrama, Govardhan parikrama. So while doing Govardhan parikrama, they heard that one wild elephant is coming through towards them. So one devotee immediately climbed on the tree. And the other devotee, he said, oh, you don't have faith in Krishna, Krishna will protect me. He said, okay, no problem. So he just stood on the center of the road. So the elephant, wild elephant came, and the elephant saw this devotee, and he took the other route. He didn't harm that devotee and left. So then this devotee who had climbed the tree, he got down. And he said, wow, well done, well done, well done. So then this person who didn't climb the tree, he asked him, I know you also have faith in Krishna, but then why you didn't stand with me? You climbed on the tree. Then he said, when Krishna has provided me this one facility, there is a tree here, I can climb on this tree, climb up on the tree and protect myself. Why should I disturb Krishna, giving him trouble to protect me? He has already made an arrangement for my protection. Why should I unnecessarily give him trouble? And why should I unnecessarily, okay, let me see whether Krishna protects me or not. This is the adamant nature. So I don't want to give trouble to Krishna when there is a facility. So similarly, we respect all the scriptures. But the problem is, if scriptures are authentic, but the interpretation is wrong. Many times people give only karmakanda. And the solution part, there is absolutely no Krishna. Krishna is out of the picture. Whenever remedy or some solutions they give, Krishna is nowhere seen. It's out of the picture. Therefore, it is wrong. If anything has no connection with Krishna, that is not authentic. But of course, there are some devotees, they also give Narsingha Mantra, and that is very good if it is connected to Krishna. So devotees should have faith. When I am chanting Krishna's holy name, I will be protected by him. And many people, they say that sadhana bhakti is not enough to attain the highest bhava. Adho shraddha tada sadhu sangha bhava prema. Sadhana bhakti is not sufficient to attain that gopi bhava, gopi prema. Our acharya said no. If you see the lives of the Shad Goswamis, Raghunath Das Goswami, every day, even at his old age, he would offer 2,000 obeisances to the devotees and the deities. Every day. Sanatan Goswami, even in the old age, he was performing Govardhan Puja every day. Srila Prabhupada, even till the last moment, he was translating the books. They never in their life showed that, okay, now sadhana bhakti is enough. Now I had to dress like a gopis or start acting like a gopis. No need. Hare Krishna mantra includes everything. All the spiritual world, all the planets are in the Hare Krishna mantra. All the bhavas, every ecstasy is there in the holy name. Chanting Hare Krishna mantra is like a boarding the train. Suppose we want to go to Vrindavan, so we take the train from Mumbai Central. We are sitting in the train. Now what we have to do for going to Vrindavan? Just keep sitting in the train. You don't have to, just don't get down from the train. That is the only thing you have to do. And what will happen? The train will do its part, everything smoothly. Sometimes you may also go to sleep, no problem. And you will find one station is passing by. Surat, Baroda, Ahmedabad. Without your knowledge, all the stations are crossed. So Ado Sraddha, Tata Sadhu Sangha, Bhajana Kriya, Anartha Nivruti, Ruchi, Asakti, Bhava, Prema, Madanakya, Madanakya, and the highest Prema of the gopis. Everything is rewarded simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra. There is no need of any separate endeavor. Absolutely. Because we are, acharyas have shown this. From Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to all the acharyas, Sadh Goswamis, Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, Gaur Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj, Prabhupada, in their whole life, they simply chanted Hare Krishna mantra. Huh. There is a difference. As on a sadhana level, when a sadhaka chants Hare Krishna mantra, that is an austerity he is chanting. But when a pure devotee who is very advanced, he also chants Hare Krishna mantra. He doesn't chant some different mantras. He also chants Hare Krishna mantra, but that is now out of love, out of ecstasy. When a devotee chants Hare Krishna mantra, advanced devotee chants Hare Krishna mantra, Rupa Goswami says, why have only one mouth and 2 ears? I wish to have thousands and thousands of mouth and millions of ears to release that Hare Krishna mantra. So there is no need of changing the process. It's not that, okay, now your Swarupa Siddha is this, your form is this, now you start acting like this, and select some personality from Braja and start. Actually, this is also true. But Hare Krishna mantra inside the heart completes that process. Without our knowledge, all that realization and purity, whatever is required, this is the glory of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And all these acharyas, there is no, all the scriptures say that Raganuga Bhakti means you have to follow the footsteps of a particular personality in the Golok. That is true. But in Kali Yuga, by the mercy of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all the acharyas, Hare Krishna mantra is just one pill. Solves all the problems. There is no need of any other endeavors. Even if someone just sitting in a small room, in the old days, till we are young, we have some physical strength, the body, we can do so many varieties of services. And what will happen if you become old? No problem. Just by sitting in your small room, take the bead bag, start chanting Hare Krishna mantra. In that small room, all the leelas of Krishna are happening. In that 10 by 10 room, Krishna's, all the Golok Vrindavan pastimes are happening in that room when that old man or old woman is chanting Hare Krishna mantra. Because spiritual Hare Krishna mantra includes everything. Even if a person is not doing anything, we say, Namacharya Haridas Thakur Ki Jai. And what is his contribution to the world? He didn't write any book. He didn't build big, big temples. He didn't do any scientific research. Nothing. He was only chanting Hare Krishna mantra. Mahaprabhu gave him the highest position. Even a Brahmana cannot imagine that position is Namacharya. throughout the creation now, the time to come, rest of the eternity, he will become Namacharya. And why? Amazing. He would just sit at the Siddha Bakul, under the Siddha Bakul, and chant his holy name. Amazing. Haridas are chanting, when we chant Hare Krishna Mantra, it is for our purification. When Haridas Thakur was chanting Hare Krishna Mantra, it was giving nourishment to the whole earth planet. It's a fact. Haridas Thakur's chanting was nourishing the whole earth planet. All the living entities and everyone was nourished by Haridas Thakur's chanting Hare Krishna Mantra. So whoever chants Hare Krishna Mantra, they are the greatest philanthropist and they are doing greatest service to the entire world. There is no other process required. One time Bhaktisiddhanta Thakurji, he was in his at Ulta Dungeon's Gaudiya Mutt, and there was a time for prasadam, lunch prasad. So he saw that temple president, he made a two lines for two rows for sitting for the devotees. One row was meant for first initiated Harinam Dikshit devotees, and the other row was meant for a second initiated, those who have got a second initiation, they are more advanced, they should sit separately. Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur Prabhupada saw this, he became so disgusted. See, do you think that these Harinam Dikshit, the first initiated people, they are less advanced than those who got second initiation? According to my opinion, these are more advanced than the second initiated. Why? Because the second initiated people, they are thinking that chanting Hare Krishna Mantra is not sufficient to go to Goloka Vrindavan. We need something else, some different mantras or something, this or that. Someone may ask, so we are chanting mantras on a thread, Gayatri mantras, is that bogus? No, it is only helping. All the mantras in this world, they have limit. They can only bring you in the mode of goodness, that's all. No mantra has a power to liberate you from this material world. Every single other mantra except Hare Krishna Mantra, they will only bring you at the level of goodness. That's all. But Hare Krishna Mantra can take us to the spiritual world, because Hare Krishna Mantra is not an ordinary mantra. It is non. Krishna has manifested in the mantras. He and Krishna and mantra is non-different. I was discussing with one devotee, and we were discussing about the 9 Navvidha Bhakti process. Archanam, Dasyam, Sakyam, Atmani, Vedanam, and also chanting Hare Krishna Mantra. So then he said, deity worship is very important. I said, yeah, it's important. Deity worship is important. But Bhagavad Vidhi, chanting Hare Krishna Mantra and listening, hearing Hare Krishna Mantra is crucial. It's not just important. And what is the proof? Of course, we are not against deity worship. It's a most integral part. Rupa Goswami says, out of 64 process of devotional service, these 5 are most important. Deity worship, Tulasi worship, associating with devotees, Bhagavad reading, staying at the Vrindavan Dham or any other Dham, and chanting Hare Krishna Mantra, isn't it? Deity worship is most important and very supportive to your Bhagavad Vidhi. And the proof is, even if someone does not enter into the altar for 6 months, does not dress a deity. We love dressing everything. I'm just giving a importance, the comparison. Even if someone does not enter in the altar for 6 months, what will happen? After 6 months, you will enter and start doing seva. Now, what I'm telling you now, don't try in your life. Just imagine if we stop chanting for 6 months, We chant every day 16 rounds. Don't try this. But if someone doesn't chant 16 rounds for 6 months, everything is ruined. 6 months is too much. Even 3-4 months is enough. If an initiated person does not chant 16 rounds just for 4, 5, 6 months, everything is finished. That now, this you cannot compare with any other 64 items of bhakti. Of course, therefore, Rupa Goswami says, all these processes are supportive, helping you to chant better. All these processes are important, but chanting Hare Krishna mantra is crucial. And therefore, we cannot take a risk of not chanting Hare Krishna mantra in our life. So, Mahaprabhu Chaitanya and Srila Prabhupada, they are so merciful. They have given such a sublime and safest process. Simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, just like a lion when roars in the jungle, all the small animals, they run away in the fear. They know, oh, lion has come. Everyone just flee everywhere. It's the power of lions roaring. When Hare Krishna mantra enters in our life, all the sinful reactions are vanished. Just like us, when sun rises in the eastern directions, eastern horizon, all the darkness is dissipated. Similarly, chanting Hare Krishna mantra brings all auspiciousness in the life of a devotee. When someone claps, is that right? Clap. When someone claps under the tree, all the birds which are sitting on the tree, they also fly. So similarly, whichever body, whatever body we are in, if we chant Hare Krishna mantra through this body, all the inauspiciousness all which are there in the body, they all fly away. And fire. When there is a forest fire, all these dry grasses, everything is burnt into ashes within the just a fraction of some moments or some minutes, right? So similarly, chanting Hare Krishna mantra is so powerful. Whoever that person is, however sinful he is or she is, chanting Hare Krishna mantra has such a potency, a person cannot even imagine of committing sins. Person cannot even imagine the committing of sin. That many sins are eradicated and finished and vanished by chanting Hare Krishna mantra. So therefore, actually they take birth in Kali Yuga, and especially after Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's appearance, we are all so fortunate that we have been given this Hare Krishna mantra, which is eternal, not in this material world, also happening in the spiritual world. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.